Welcome to Ask Al, presented by Quad Plus. Here's today's question. MV drives are getting lower in horsepower. At what point do you feel they become more effective and more economical than a low voltage drive? So it's an interesting thing happening in the market today, and there does seem to be a proliferation of medium voltage drives that are going lower and lower in horsepower. I've seen them down at 200 horsepower. I think there's a couple things driving this trend. Certainly semiconductors, in that the voltage ratings are going up, you know, current ratings at the same time. So they're an enabler for the, certainly for 2300 base voltage inverters. Now, the other thing that I believe is driving this is the reduced cost to develop the systems and certainly to install and maintain the systems. Today we have Carl Heideck with us, and he's going to talk a bit about his experiences in this market. Carl, welcome.
Thanks, Al.
So, Carl, where do you see the point right now where it's more economical, or users should start considering perhaps using a medium voltage drive where you traditionally use a low voltage drive?
The breakpoint at which we see for medium voltage drives tends to be in very low horsepower range. And depending on the application, it can be as low as, say, 200 horsepower, somewhere between 200 up to, say, 500 horsepower. Commonly now, we are seeing more and more customers requesting that we quote the medium voltage solution at 350 horsepower applications.
Okay, so I've heard you speak in the past about planning factors. Could you expand on that?
The planning factors that are important for a drive application project really come back to some key items that really drive the total cost of the project. It's not just the drive itself, but also the existing substation, the upstream transformer, existing switchgear, and on the downstream side, the downstream cabling, potentially any other additional magnetics that might be required in the circuit, like a step-up transformer, output filter, something like that. All of those come into play and are important for the end user when they're making this decision on what's the right way to go on their drive selection application.
Okay, so great. Let's talk about cost a bit. So how does price compare, for example, between for both the cost of the units, but then also the installation?
The low voltage drive at the very low end of the range, say of 100, 200 horsepower, still is lower cost than equivalently rated medium voltage drive. However, when you do look at the project, you need to actually look at everything else that goes into the system before you make your decision. Because if you look only at the individual component, you might be led to the wrong decision. Cable, for example, cable distance between the drive and the motor actually has a more significant impact on the total project than the drive itself. Cabling issue is something actually we did quite a bit of research on a few years ago when we started looking at the viability of using medium voltage in lower horsepower ratings. And what we know is that a 480 volt system, equivalently rated 480 volt system, actually draws 9 times more current for the same horsepower. So at almost 10 times the current, you can imagine what that does to the size and ultimately the cost of the cable. The cost of the cable, as you go up in horsepower and require more parallel connections of the cable, can actually increase the cost of an installation to a few $100,000 on an individual basis.
All right, how about now from a performance perspective? You know, are MV drives, for example, more robust than a low voltage drive? You know, take a scenario like with line transients.
The low voltage drives actually are, I had said earlier, lower cost in the low horsepower range compared to medium voltage. But when we look at robustness related to its fault tolerance capability, the medium voltage drive solution, particularly one that's a cascaded H-bridge that could be augmented with a feature like cell bypass, will actually give a much higher uptime performance compared to an equivalently rated low voltage drive. And the reason for that is low voltage drive, regardless of the manufacturer, will ultimately have a single point of failure because they're actually designed down to the minimal number of components. With the minimal number of components, if you lose one, then the drive has no choice but to stop.
Okay, so where do you see the ideal situation? Like if I'm a user and you know, where you think it's like a no-brainer that, okay, this is a perfect candidate for a medium voltage drive, to move into the traditional low voltage space.
In a greenfield scenario, we do see now that more and more the customers are actually directing us to quote medium voltage down, say, to 300, 350 horsepower and up. And in a lot of cases, that might be driven based upon how they want to, how they plan their, use their switchgear design for the facility, the way that they want to support or utilize the KVAs on the upstream transformers for the facility. And also they're looking at the total cost associated with the cabling for the complete plant compared to a low voltage solution. We do see a fair amount of soft starters that have been installed years ago, usually on lowest initial cost type design, where a customer realizes after the system is running that they could utilize the benefits of replacing that soft starter with a medium voltage drive. The drive itself, what's nice about the newer designs on medium voltage drive is that the footprint is now small enough that it actually can be retrofitted into an existing scenario where a soft starter previously existed, and the price point is much lower to where it actually is economically viable and in most cases can be justified on payback analysis alone.
Great. Well, we'll certainly see what the future holds with regards to semiconductors and where this business goes and just how low in the horsepower range MV drives will go. Carl, thank you very much for your time. So Quad Plus can help you make the decisions regarding low voltage to medium voltage drives, when is the best time to use them, and certainly which is the best type of medium voltage inverter for your application. If you'd like any information or assistance, don't hesitate to give us a call or send us an email. And as always, if there's a topic you'd like us to cover in a future video, just send me an email at al@quadplus.com. Thanks for watching. Remember, always work safe, lock out, and tag out.